So a career high 5 interceptions for Big Ben in that loss, as we just heard from Antonietta. Stephen A., is this a big deal or no big deal?
It's a very, very big deal. And Ryan Clark, especially, this is for you. I want to say this right. No, seriously, because I respect the hell out of you and your opinion. And obviously, you're a Super Bowl champion with the Pittsburgh Steelers. You know how much I love Coach Mike T. Got mad respect for Le'Veon Bell and Antonio Brown and all of these guys. I want to state something for the record as the diehard Steelers fan here on the record. I'm not playing. I think Big Ben should retire. I think he should retire. If you're going to sit up there and run your mouth the way that you run your mouth, exuding no confidence whatsoever, after spending an entire offseason, you know, articulating a level, an alarming level of disinterest, if not at least trepidation, as to whether or not you want to play this football game, and then you go out and you wet the bed and play like straight garbage like you did yesterday, just go ahead and leave. Just go ahead and leave. I'm not saying he should leave because of one afternoon. I'm not saying he should leave because of 5 interceptions, as awful as it gets, which was a career worst for him, including 2 pick sixes, by the way. I'm not even saying he should leave because the Jacksonville Jaguars was talking junk about him after the game, about how flustered he looked or what have you. I'm saying that if you are the star, the future Hall of Famer, the 2-time Super Bowl champion, supposedly the leader of this team, because that's what you called yourself a couple of weeks ago when you were busy calling out Antonio Brown for his histrionics in, you know, in Baltimore, then you come out, you wet the bed like that, and you talk about maybe I don't have it no more. Maybe I'm just not there. Why should anybody believe in you? You clearly don't believe in yourself. Go to hell home. Retire. Give it up. Well, walk away. Go home with the wife and kids and chill
Stephen
out
A.,
and
don't
do what you got to do.
Do you think he was being facetious, though?
Wait a minute. I don't think he was being facetious. Do I look like I think he was being facetious? This man seems to have lost his confidence. He seems to not care about how his demeanor is resonating with the rest of his team. That's my concern. I'm not talking about his play because it was bad. It's one game. I'm talking about the attitude. I've been challenging everybody to tell me, where do you see the interested, the hyped, the enthusiastic Big Ben Roethlisberger about playing the sport of football? You either want to play or you don't. That's why I'm saying what I'm saying.
That's right. That's right. In a full contact sport, if you start thinking about retiring, what do they say? You're already retired. Stephen A., Andre Ward announced on First Take, the pound-for-pound champ, he was hanging him up, undefeated. Why? He didn't want to put his body through it anymore. You know, we've seen this before. Lennox Lewis, heavyweight champ. We've seen it with football players. I could still do it if I wanted to. The smart ones realize that means I can't do it. It's this, there's no difference, and so they walk away. And Roethlisberger was talking retirement in the offseason. He came back anyway. He's taken a ton of hits in his career. We've all seen this. And he's part of that same draft class with Eli Manning and Phillip Rivers, and all three of them seem to be in decline. And you might ask, well, there are other guys like Peyton and Brady who played until 40 or maybe beyond at a very high level. What's up with these guys? Well, none of these guys were as good as Peyton or Brady. They were really good, but they're in their mid, getting to be upper 30s. They're all in decline. Roethlisberger, particularly because of his physical style, is showing it. And you know, what else can you say? That's bad Ben Roethlisberger. It looked like a guy who should indeed hang it up. Doesn't mean he can't have good games. It's possible, of course. But that is not a good quarterback right now.
Yeah, Ryan.
And it's the same guy who was talking retirement.
Well, I think we're trying to take too much at one time. If you talk about the performance, it was awful. I mean, he had 2 tip picks. He threw some late picks in the game. Obviously, you can't defend his performance. You can't defend the way he's played this season as a whole. If you look at a lot of their struggles, it is because of the quarterback position. You had Maurkice Pouncey come out and say it was a team thing. Yesterday wasn't a team thing. Yesterday was Big Ben not playing the way that Big Ben has to play for this team to be close to what we thought it could be. Here's a bigger issue. I don't mind Ben talking about retirement. I don't mind what I thought was a sarcastic, maybe I don't have it anymore, because I've been around Big Ben. He don't believe that he doesn't have it anymore. He's also very dramatic. Big Ben will diagnose his own injury. Big Ben will tell you exactly what's going on, exactly how it happens, how bad he's feeling, and then he comes out and balls. So what he said after the game isn't an issue. Here's the issue with Pittsburgh, Big Ben, everybody for me. We talked about him speaking of retirement. Now let's look at this team. This team is full of a lot of young players, a lot of these new age, it's all about me type guys. Big Ben didn't come in Pittsburgh in that type of environment. I was there. It wasn't those type of people. It was a family. Pittsburgh is a normally quiet place. And what I mean about that, it's a place about hard workers. It's a city that's about family. It's a city that's about togetherness. That's the way the Rooneys run the team. Come to camp, it's about Le'Veon Bell. Will he really report to camp? Will he sign a new deal? Martavis Bryant, when is he going to be able to play? And so then now you go to the next thing, and it's the anthem, and then it's Antonio Brown, and now it's this. It's a problem with the whole team. It's been a problem on the field. Yes, his statements are not a problem. The whole team has to figure out a way to focus on football.
Ryan. Yo, I'm not letting you off the hook with that. I'm not letting you. You are a Steeler, you are a champion, and you know your damn football, and you know the personalities. I heard you going off a few weeks ago about Antonio Brown.
Right.
We could point to the 10 receptions for 157 yards that he received yesterday and say that's a problem, because it almost seemed like they had to cater to him after what transpired, which is not
for sure.
It's antithetical to what we know the Steelers to be. By the way, 15 rushes for 47 yards by Le'Veon Bell against Jacksonville's defense, against the run, which was the worst in the NFL, making Bilal Powell look like Jim Brown just a week earlier at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. All of these are problems. But my point to you is all the things you pointed to was after Big Ben Roethlisberger had been on a record contemplating retirement because of the punishment his body had taken and because of the level of
Steve
apathy.
A.
That was after Le'Veon.
Well,
that was before Le'Veon Bell and Antonio Brown.